probably a top three snake in, or a top three Ken in all of North America, but he's gonna get going here. He's gonna use some movement with these platforms. Chronos is gonna poke, but he's not able to get anything off of it. Because I just mentioned to Tatsu to get some stage positioning, but Chronos is gonna go high in order to get some of that back. He'll get a lot back. Renane's doing. Smirk landing on an admittedly on an obvious C4. Sorry, I'm still waking. I'm still warming up my solo commentary. It's been a long day, but yeah, these two are just playing well-rounded neutral here. The grenade will send Smirk flying, but Chronos nowhere near his zip code, so he's not going to be able to get anything off of it though. Chronos is looking for his win condition here, but Smirk is going to have to put on some damage, and a grenade into up air will take it for Chronos. He'll take that first stock, and he's going to try and get as much extra damage as he can in order to make these next couple stocks a little bit easier for him. That needs the C4, possibly a little unnecessarily, but Smirk is going to claw his way back. Chronos is not letting him, leaving him with any breathing space. That grapple with up air, and he will be sticking on the air dodge. That might have transferred to Snake. Smirk is aware. It's actually on Smirk now. But he will get the Shoryu in order to take the stock. But he's taken lots of damage. It's now on Smirk again. I believe it's still on Chronos. Chronos has to be extremely careful that this doesn't fight him. It's on Smirk. This is just a game of transferring it back and forth, but actually the grenade throw will mess it up a little bit. That would've had that sticky not fallen off there, that would have been a free kill for Chronos, 10 times out of 10. But because that sticky fell off, which I believe is 8 seconds? I think it's 8 seconds that it falls off. But, yeah, Chronos is just keeping Smirk in the air, where Ken, not really strong in the air. So, he's just keeping Smirk in extremely uncomfortable positions, and he's just playing mind games now. Alright, it's on Chronos now, I'm sorry. And it'll just fall off. He's gonna set up a ledge trap, tries to go for that forward smash, but it will not land. Smirk is faints going deep, and the medium Shoryu will take the stock, but Smirk has been playing from behind this whole game. An up air will get him into a juggle situation. He's able to get down using the platform mode. Tries to go. Smirk is trying to get as much stage position as he can so Snake has less stuff to trap, but he just gives it away for free in spite of that. Smirk is just using movement to try and get something going, but he has been nowhere near Chronos, so he's not really going to be able to get much going here. Alright, gets a decent chain going, and the grenade damage will deal a little bit of self-damage to Chronos. Smirk is playing very, very patiently, and he's just gonna focus attack cancel right into the loving foot of Snake's up tilt. So that will be game one. Going the way of Chronos, and just an absolute slaughter fest, where Chronos had a fair into a sticky setup twice in the same game. What?
I just gotta be a little bit calmer, a little bit quieter. This headset, man. It's so hard to tell. I'm not spatially cognizant enough, so I gotta work on that. So.
Alright, just gotta cool down a little bit from you two. Smirk with a, or Chronos with a valid argument, so I'm gonna be a little bit quieter. But Smirk is gonna try and keep Chronos cornered here, but isn't able to get anything going for long. Smirk is gonna pressure using Chronos' own grenades though, so he's got that going for him. Feints a sticky, but dashes back instead. or Smirk doing whatever he can in order to pressure. The damage is within 20%. It's relatively close, but that damage will add up quickly for Chronos. These two are just going to play a range game. Smirk not going to land on the C4, and they're just going to play a game at range. Smirk setting up a tech chase, but doesn't get anything off of it. The Tatsu saving him from the suit from the dash tag. And the Tatsu will be punished after Chronos falls right out of it. So, we are going to continue. Chronos has big damage on Chronos. A jab into Shoryu will take it. They're both going to play out the play extremely patiently. Smirk's got the stage positioning here. Smirk knows what his win condition is. And a roundhouse kick will take that. It's still fairly even. Smirk having a little, or Chronos having a little bit of an advantage in terms of damage. That damage will continue to add up. Chronos is just gonna pull grenades. Chronos gets caught pushing a button there, or with that down tilt. Chronos will take some damage from Ken, but that grenade will get it, will almost kill, but it won't kill just yet. Chronos looking for possibly a grenade backer. World throw. Gonna focus attack right through, and is actually gonna use that grenade explosion in order to tech and get back to stage. Not able to punish Chronos landing right back on stage though, but a down throw up tilt will take it for Chronos. It's no longer even. Chronos has taken massive damage. And he's just going to continue going for it. Smirk is gonna air dodge to avoid the C4 setup. He sees the pressure. Smirk is gonna try and get some pressure going. He's got Chronos in the corner. He's gonna get an up air, but isn't able to get anything out of it. Roundhouse kill, just barely killing. Smirk in a position where he's really gonna have to clutch up here. Smirk is gonna claw back. Smirk's gonna get him off stage. Getting that close jab that Ken has. Chronos is gonna try and keep Ken out. Threat of these grenades is real. He's actually gonna get hit by one, but Chronos isn't able to follow up properly. You have to kill him. That's actually going to kill. That forward tilt, a very strong forward tilt. Two hits. I believe at 130, 135, you can down throw it, and that becomes a true kill confirm at the ledge at least. So, you know, Chronos using his options extremely well, and not letting the fact that Smirk was trying time and time again to claw back. Get to him. Just playing clean snake gameplay all around. So we'll see if Smirk has anything going there. We definitely saw some stuff going there for Smirk at the end of that set. It was really, really close for most of the set up to that last stock perhaps. But Smirk is gonna get the first hit. He's actually gonna catch Smirk Chronos pushing a button. Chronos went down using that down air though. Tatsu won't hit. But he's gonna get hit caught in end lag with that. He's prime. I can't tell where it's at though. Smirk is just gonna off pressure. That mortar will hit. Smirk is just keeping Smirk in a bad position. Good timing on that getup. Shoryu actually either whiffing or Chronos spot dodging right through it in order to get the kill on that F tilt. Chronos or Smirk is gonna. Alright. Just gonna let the grenade do its thing and he's just gonna Shoryu right into it. So that's a stock. We're dead even now. So we'll continue being dead even. But Chronos is just gonna try and tack on a punch of damage, which he will with a down air and I believe a tilt as well, throwing in there for good measure, and he's just running away with it. So he got a grenade in the back air. He's tacking on damage. Smirk has 70% decline. Will he do it? the back throw will give him some stage position. The Nair, I believe, will give him a good amount of damage. And suddenly, it's within 20. Smirk is just going to let the grenade explode without doing anything on the platform. Chronos just catching with Chronos running in aggressively with the C4. And Smirk actually getting the kill confirm, but it's not going to kill just yet. Snake is a beefy character. And the C4 will take it for Chronos. And just like that, Smirk is on his set stock here. But he is not out by any means. Smirk is going to continue. Tries to get the downer, but will not get it because of the sort of bipod or that up B that Snake has. And he will get the stock, and he's only taken 7.5% damage. At this point, it's anyone's game. Smirk gonna use movement in order to trick Chronos. He's not able to get anything going immediately, though. He's gonna catch the tech. Chronos is gonna catch the tech in place with a downer. He's gonna continue to harass with grenades. Chronos keeping Smirk in a somewhat bad, vulnerable position. But he's not gonna get hit by the C4 setup. Chronos possibly timing it just a little late. Down smash into Roundhouse Kick will attack on some damage, and it's within 0.2%. Chronos will throw a grenade in order to get Smirk into a juggle position. Chronos is going to keep on attacking on damage. A roundhouse kick will give him extremely good stage positioning and extremely good damage. Smirk trying to use movement. Tries to get the shield rip, but it's because of that he's not able to get up shield in time with the grenade explosion. Smirk is going to continue to harass from afar. He's going to try and catch Smirk trying to catch in aggressively, but Smirk probably knows this. Back throw. Won't matter as Chronos will get back to stage. Smirk at a damage deficit, and he will be caught up tilting. Right into the loving foot of up tilt. Yeah, sorry about that.